last class, okay, last class we have studied about in spermatogenesis. Today I have discussed about in oogenesis. Okay, spermatogenesis is the production of sperm from the or the development of sperm from the spermatogonia. Okay, today I have discussed about in sperm oogenesis. What is the oogenesis? The process, because it is the oogenesis ova and one of the ovum is also called as the egg. It's developed in the female gametes. One of the female gametes. That gametes is the fusion with the male gametes, the formation into zygote and form into young ones. Okay. Today I have discussed about only the oogenesis. What is the oogenesis? The production of ova from the primordial cells, primordial germ cells. Okay, because these are the developed only in the ovary. The ovary is the one of the female reproductive organ. Okay, female reproductive organ is the gametes. The which gametes is the present in the female organ? Or the which gamete is the present in the female? Is the ova. Ova is one of the female gamete. Male gamete is the spermatozoa. Okay. The oogenesis, the production or the formation of the ova from the primordial germ cells in the ovary. Ovary is the primordial germ cells. The oogenesis, okay, the oogenesis, the again divisible in three steps, the same steps present in the spermatogenesis. The first step, the one is the multiplication phase, growth phase, another one is maturation phase. Now the multiplication phase, growth phase, another one is maturation phase, okay. In this, the multiplication phase, the primordial germ cells are developed from the complete or entire cortex of the ovary. Ovary is the cortex region of the cells. So, here I call them the primordial germ cells. Primordial germ cells, these are the existing cells. For some time, last class we have heard it. Okay, the primordial germ cells, these are the diploid number of chromosomes. Diploid number of chromosomes are next to the 2N. 2N and rest 2. 2N, it means that is the 46 chromosomes. How the N and rest 2? Only for 23 chromosomes. Okay. The 2N, it means that 46 chromosomes in these cells. Okay. The primordial germ cells undergo the mitosis division continuously or the proliferation, mitotic proliferation in the primordial germ cells. These germ cells undergo the mitotic division form into oogonia. Alli spermatogonia cell anta helidre but illella oogonia. Okay, what oo means that it is ova or ovum or egg. Okay, idra nenpidukoru spermatosperm andre endre sperm is the female gamete, male gamete. Okay, ova andre female gamete, egg andre endre same female gamete. Okay, the primordial germ cells, the primordial germ cells are formed from the entire cortex of the ovary. These primordial cells are the diploid number of chromosomes present in the primordial germ cells. These primordial germ cells undergo the mitotic division continuously, continuous mitotic division or the continuous proliferation. Okay, that proliferation form into the number of oogonia cells. Number of oogonia cells. These oogonia cells are the diploid number of chromosomes. How much chromosomes are present in this cells? These cells, only for 46 the chromosomes are present in these cells, the oogonia cells. Are they divided from the primordial germ cells? Okay, these the 2N number of chromosomes undergo the, it's not undergo the, this the oogonia cells are the diploid number of chromosomes, because the R equal mitosis division, the parental body divided into two equal cells. Erdu equal cell daughter cells agirbeku adhe yenandre idu ee cell primordial germ cell divide aagi two equal andre idu illestide chromosomes two illestide avada 2n yenandre the equal amount of cytoplasm, equal amount of nucleus and equal amount of chromosomes present in the both cells. Okay, the same as again undergo the, because it is the proliferation, you know, continuously division of the proliferation, you know, continuously division. These oogonia cells undergo the enlargement, the specialized cell, the formation of the specialized cell is called as primary oocyte. Okay, primary oocyte is also called as growth phase.
If you remember, the multiplication phase, what mean by multiplication?
Oogonia cells are the multiple. All oogonia cells, the primordial germ cells undergo the mitotization. Form into cells. These cells are called as oogonia. And the one into sarcus called the multiplication. मल्टिप्लिकेशन सेलूशन मल्टिप्लिकेशनोजेनाजेनसेज condensed cytoplasm and condensed nucleus. Okay, these are the primary oocytes. These are called as oogonia. Okay, this called as oocytes because it's enlarged cell. Condensed cytoplasm, condensed nucleus is present. Okay, so why it is condensed nucleus? Why it is called as larger in size? Larger cells in the oogonia cells. ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ರೆಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಡಿಎನ್ಎ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದಿ ಸೆಲ್. ಅದೇನ್ರಿ, ಒಂದು ಡಿಎನ್ಎ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಇದ್ದು ಅವು ರೆಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಗ್ತದ, ನಾವು ಅಥವಾ ರೆಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸೈಜ್ ನ ಅದು ತನ್ನ ಡುಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಅಥವಾ ರೆಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ತನ್ನ ಡಾಟರ್ ಸೆಲ್ ಡಾಟರ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಬಿಡ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತದ, ಆರ್ ಎನ್ ಎ ಸಿಂಥಸಿಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದ. ಓಕೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಏನಂತ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಹೋಗ್ತದ.
ಸೈಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸಮ್ ಟು ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಇದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ದೀಸ್ ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ಓಸೈಟ್ಸ್ fights for larger again because it is two reasons are there. One reason is pre-vitellogenesis.
ಸೈಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸಮ್
ಈ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಪ್ರೀ ಅಂದ್ರ ಈ ವಿಟಲಿನೋ, ವಿಟಲಿನೋ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನ್ರಿ ಅಂತ ಫುಡ್ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡ್ರಿ. ವಿಟಲಿನೋ ವಿಟಲೈನ್, ಓಕೆ, ವಿಟಲಿನೋ ಫುಡ್ ಅಂತ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡ್ರಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಪ್ರೀ ವಿಟಲಿನೋ ಜೆನೆಸಿಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರೀ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ಮುಂಚೆ ಏನ್ ಸಿಂಥಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದ, ಏನ್ರಿ, ಏನ್ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಆಗ್ತದ, ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅನದರ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೈಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸಮ್. ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೈಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸಮ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫೇಸ್. ಹಾಗೇನ್ರಿ, ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆದಾಗ ಏನ್ಬೇಕು, ಫುಡ್ ಬೇಕು. ಒಂದು ಸೆಲ್ಲು ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಒಂದು ಓವ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಆಗಿ ಸೆಲ್ ಡಿವಿಷನ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಏನ್ಬೇಕ್ರಿ, ಫುಡ್ ಬೇಕು. ಹಾಗೆ ಯುಟಿಲಿಯೋಜೆನ್ಸಿಸ್ ಹೋದ್ರೆ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಟೋರೇಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಫುಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್. ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಸ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಸ್ ಟು ದಿ ಎನ್ಲಾರ್ಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ಓಸೈಟ್ಸ್. ಯುಟಿಲಿಯೋಜೆನ್ಸಿಸ್ ಹೋದ್ರೆ ನ್ಯೂಕ್ಲಿಯಸ್ ಮತ್ತು ಸೈಟೋಪ್ಲಾಸಮ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಯುಟಿಲಿಯೋಜೆನ್ಸಿಸ್ ಹೋದ್ರೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಫುಡ್ ಸಿಂಥಸಿಸ್ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಯೋಗ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ, ಯೋಗ increases. Yolk is developed in this heterogeneous. Heterogeneous is the food of the yolk. Develop as the ovule as the heterogeneous nucleus of the cytoplasm increase as the two carbon in the 2N. This primary results in the larger cell in eugenesis. Okay, again, this primary oocyte undergo the meiotic division. Okay, undergo the meiotic division. And the first meiotic division is the meiotic division 1. Okay, this is the first meiotic division. It is also called as reductional division. It is also called as reductional division. But the chromosomes are similar in both cells because these are the haploid number of chromosomes. But the one cell having the lack of cytoplasm, okay, अथवा less cytoplasm present in one cell and a large amount of cytoplasm present in another cell of the meiotic first division. Why it is called as reductional division? Because it reduces the chromosome number from the parent. Parent will have the chromosome number कड़ी ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಪರ್ಮಟೋಜೆನ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನು ನೀವು ಕಲ್ತಿದ್ದೀರಿ ಹೌದಾ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ अथवा the first reduction division smaller cell is called as first polar body. First polar body. Okay. And again another one is the useful of the secondary oocyte. Secondary larger cells from reduction division is called as the secondary oocyte. And again the meiotic two division. Okay. Meiotic first like meiotic two divisions are there. Meiotic two division M2. Okay. इधर M2
Neglected. These polar bodies are neglected. It means that it is the excreta, okay, like that. It is the waste material or the waste cells in the oogenesis. Okay, this large cell undergo the meiotic two division. This one meiotic two division. Again, the unequal chromosomes. Okay, sorry, unequal cytoplasm present in one cell and large number of cytoplasm present in another cell. This one as also called as the secondary polar bodies. For the secondary polar bodies, because these are also called as secondary polar bodies. These the meiotic division, the formation of the meiotic division two cell is called as ootid. That is called ootids. Ootids. Ali spermatids are called. Do you remember? Ootids are called. Because these ootids are next development to ova or ovum. Okay. These first polar bodies from the meiotic one. Second polar bodies from the second polar bodies from the meiotic two division. These cells are called as negligens. It means that it is the these are the waste materials. Okay, these are waste or rejected. Okay, when we have given the la. Again, these large cells undergo the meiotic division. Again, these cells produce large cell. One is large cell, another one is smaller cell. This cell is negligens, and another the cell from the meiotic two division are called as ootids. That ootids then next develop into ova. Okay, every ova means that is the egg. It's also called as egg. Ova. Okay, इधर एक मतलब develop after the formation of the process, the formation of the ova from the primordial germ cells is called as oogenesis. That oogenesis again divisible in three parts. Okay, three steps are there: multiplication, growth phase, and maturation phase. Multiplication phase is the primordial germ cells are the presenter in the ovary. Because these are the formation of the primordial cells. Entire cortex are reason of the ovary. Okay, these primordial germ cells are undergo the mitotic division or the continuously proliferation form into Eugonia cells. This process is called as multiplication step. Okay, so multiplication phase. The larger cells that present in the spermatogonia cells, oogenesis. Okay, larger cells present in the oogenesis. How to the largest? Okay, how large are they? Because two reasons are there. One is pre-vitaline oogenesis, another is teleogenesis. The pre-vitaline oogenesis phase is only for the increases there, the nucleus and the cytoplasm. The vitelliogenesis to increases the development of yolk and another one is food. Food मतलब यो करना develop पर तैयार करना आ गए this larger cell is also called as the primary oocytes is called as growth phase. यार growth आता था because increases their size और तरना size में increase मारता था आ गए ना ये important part था and another one is 2N again divisible in mitotic or the start will undergo the meiotic division first. Meiotic division is also called a reduction in division because it is reduces chromosome number form into unequal daughter cells in the meiotic first because the unequal cytoplasm present in both meiotic first daughter cells. Okay, the lack amount of cytoplasm present in that cell is called as first polar bodies and another one is the larger cytoplasm present in the another cell is called as secondary oocyte. Now again, the both cells are undergoing meiotic two. These polar bodies produce secondary polar bodies because the less amount of cytoplasm and another one is the larger the secondary oocyte is undergoing meiotic two division. One is larger cell, another one is smaller cell. These smaller cells, these polar bodies are negligent or the waste materials. It is rejected and larger cell is called as oocytes. These oocytes undergo the formation into the ova because this ova or egg is called as female gamete
anta kartara.
Hagagi the oogenesis is very important in your examination.